Gold traded bearish throughout this week and closed the week at 1810. It failed to break past 1850. I have told several times in my daily and weekly analysis that only if it trades above 1850, you can expect it to trade bullish. Failing to break past, it has dropped and closed the week at 1810. Now, also, we have seen that it was trading in this bullish channel. It has closed below this channel. That is first observation. Second, it is very close to the first next strongest support, that is 1800-1780. So now what to expect next week, which position you should take in order to profit, we will see with the help of charts followed with indicators, and towards the end I will give you the trading levels and strategy for next week. Do watch till the end, listen to it carefully, trade as per the levels, and yes, do not forget to like, share, subscribe and comment. Do not forget to press the bell icon, which keeps you updated with the twice a day analysis which I share for gold along with the targets. Let's start. Now see, firstly on the weekly charts, it was trading so far in this bullish channel. This time it has broke past this channel and traded below. Now what to expect? See, next is, you can see on the weekly charts, 1800 and 1791. This is a very strong base here, because below that only we can expect that 1740, 1723 levels can be seen. Now why these levels are important, we will also look into that. But right now it appears 1800, 1791 is something you should look out for next week. Only and only if it trades below these levels, then we can confirm that there is further bearishness in gold and it may try to retrace more. Also, if you look at these two candles, you can see increasing body size, increasing body size, increasing bearishness. That is what you can confirm. At the same time, if you just connect the dots here, you can find this is an expanding, or this is in a channel in which it is trying to trade. 1791 certainly going to be the next support. Also, why 1791 is important, you can see the highs and the lows, the Fibonacci retracement, you can find out this is almost 38% retracement levels from the bottom we had seen at around 1617 levels. At the same time, you can also see that it is reversed precisely from 76.4% of the retracement levels from the highs here. Now, yes, if it breaks 1790, 1780 zone, you can expect that next we might see 1740, 1723 levels. We have to be careful, we have to be watchful at around this zone. This is going to be an important support zone, because see, there are two perspectives to look at it. First is, it has failed to go past the highs and it is reversed from there. But at the same time, the second perspective is that it is still well above the bottom, and the bottom here is far away at 1620, which is a very strong support base. And see, if it has seen a rise here, and if you consider the Fibonacci from 1960 to 1617, you can find 1790, 1788, again the 50% retracement levels. So from the near term, if you consider this as the highs, it is retracing to the 50% levels, and possibly a rise from there can be expected. First part, 1780, 1788, 1791, in fact till 1780 you should be watchful. Below that we may see it hitting 1748, 1740, and then further lows can be expected. That is the first part to it. Now see, this is on the weekly charts. Let's have a look at the daily charts as well. Now see, on the daily charts, couple of sharp candles, retracement at this point. I told you this is just a retracement, possibly a break can be expected, and since then it has just traded in this bearish channel, and you can find out it is still trying to give you lower highs, lower lows every time. But this time, if you see at this candle failed or shied away from achieving the bottom. It took its time in order to achieve that, and hence you have to be watchful of 1800 and 1788-90 zone, rather till 1780. Be careful there. It can possibly reverse achieving those levels. That is the first part. Only bullish confirmation, as I have told several times, is if it trades above 1850 levels. Yes, possibly beyond that, there could be a little retracement where you can expect it to trade bullish here. Till that time, we have to be watchful and we have to be observant. Now, this is not yet bullish for sure. Right now, it is trading in the bearish and retracement levels. Now, this is on the daily charts. Let's have a look at the monthly chart. Now, on the monthly charts, after three strong bullish candles, there is one red candle this time, but this candle also has achieved further highs before looking forward to a drop. Now, if you connect the dots here, you will find that it is trying to trade in this. Possibly, if it continues to drop from here, we can see sharper moves, but then there is a strong base on the downside, which is making me still cautious of this, that highs retracement, and possibly there could be a second wave which might bring it further highs, which might take it to further higher level. Now also remember, after three big bullish candle, this is first red candle, and this month of February is about to get over. Just two trading sessions are left. I will be definitely watch for where it closes. Possibly once, because see, it is trying to create a symmetry. It may try to close the month at around these levels here, and possibly the second candle might take it or form a symmetry like this. And hence, in the month of March also, probably it may try to take it a little down, take it till towards 1720, 1740 zone. And at those levels, we will see how it behaves. This is just my expectation. And now this is on the candles purely. And also remember, this is the first red candle. There is always a possibility of a second red candle there. And hence, in the month of March also, probably a little bearishness can be seen. And in that case, till the time it trades below 1900, because see, it can rise before looking forward to a drop. That is also very much possible. Now, let's have a look with the help of indicators. What are the indicators are suggesting? And indicators on the daily chart. See, first of all, now it is trading below the 20, 50, 100 period moving average. This is clear here. Also, here you can see the 20 and 50 period moving average trading with divergence. This is entered into near-term bearishness. And now I'll wait for this 20 period to cross over below 100, and that will be a confirmation of further bearishness here. Right now, definitely it is trying to trade bearish, as these are trading divergent. Possibly we have to look forward for 20 period moving average to start moving up, and for that it needs a couple of green candles, sharper green candles. At the same time, now it is trading at the bottom of the Bollinger Bands, and the width of the Bollinger Band seeing getting narrowed. Possibly for next week, I will be watchful of 1810, 1800 and then 1788, 91 zone. Yes, these three levels, if taken, if breached, certainly it will call for further bearishness, as it could possibly bounce back achieving those levels. Now, if you look at the directional movement, this is divergent, this is bearish. A stochastic has come to oversold levels again. The MACD is still trading bearish and it is still trading divergent. But look at the MACD, how far the distance it has covered. See the rise here. At this, if you recall in my analysis, I told you gold is going overbought. Possibly a drop is required, and see how sharp the drop we have seen. Now also one must look at, see the rise here and the bottom levels here. See, right now it is at a comfortable zone at minus 20. It is still got a little room. But then a little room on the downside means there is always a possibility of a stronger recovery, because it has seen now good drop levels, good downward levels here. If you look at RSI, RSI has also come to oversold zone, and historically gold does not trade neither into oversold zone nor into overbought zone for long. It does not stay there. So possibly that is what also makes 1788, 91 zone a very strong support levels. Else what it may try to do, it can try to recover a bit before taking it further down. What we had seen with the stochastic here, it tried to move up and then it has again come back to oversold levels. Now let's have a look at the weekly chart. Now on the weekly chart, see 20 and 50 period moving average, 50 and 100 period moving averages are here at 1810 levels, very strong support, and the 20 period moving average is still looking up. It wants to, it is willing to cross over on the upside. Now this is also situated at 1790, 1780 zone, and hence this zone again is going to be increasingly important for gold. Till the time it sustains, possibility of a reversal also exists here, and hence we may see a range bound week again. Directional movement is bullish here on the weekly charts, trying to converge crossover for a sell. The stochastic has come to oversold zone. See, it traded overbought for a while, and in 3 weeks it has just come to oversold zone. And if you look at the MACD, now see MACD on the weekly charts here, you can see a highs there, and then this sharp drop has been seen where it has formed the bottom at 1620. Now it has formed the highs at around same levels, trying to converge crossover for a sell entry, and possibly once it crosses over, it may take a little time for it to recover this time. So right now it is trying to form a complete bottom, but also remember the highs for gold are still far away, and till the time it crosses over, trades divergent, do not consider this as bearish. Possibly it may take one or two more red candles. If it reverses from here, possibly consider that it has a strong bullishness and it may continue to diverge and achieve the highs here. So this week will decide which direction it wants to take. RSI on the weekly charts, after achieving the highs here, has seen a good drop here too. Now let's have a look at the monthly charts. On the monthly charts, precisely reversing from the top of the Bollinger Bands, coming back to the support, 20 months average at 1800 levels, 1790, certainly very, very good support there. Below that, it can try to stretch the drop further. Directional movement on the monthly charts is bullish. Stochastic is overbought. Certainly, this candle, when the month closes, will try to bring it a little down. And hence, let's see what the next candle brings. Now look at the MACD on the monthly charts. It has also come to comfortable levels. Now see the movement of gold so far. Historically, you will find the bottom here, then this rise. Now it has come back to almost same levels and it is looking forward to converge crossover. This is an interesting observation because see, right now this monthly candle will make it diverge a little. However, if it crosses over again, we have seen it several times, couple of times that it tried to cross over but failed to do so. Again, traded with divergence, traded bearish. This time again, it is trying to cross over. If it does, certainly that will be an indication of a reversal. The RSI is looking down, indicating little bearishness here. So we have seen the charts, we have seen the indicators. Time for me to define the levels and trading strategy for you so that you can find the levels which I mark, where I mention great strong support and resistance level. You need to be watchful of those levels. Also, always trade as per the trailing stop loss so that in case of a reversal, your trade closes in profit. Now, yes, if you want to learn this art of trading profitably, you should join my mentorship batch. The next batch starts in first week of March. Do not miss this opportunity. Reach out to me for more details. My Telegram and email IDs are mentioned in the channel and video description. Definitely the strategy start will help you become a profitable and proficient trader. Now next week, first of all, 1820 levels, which was the stronger resistance earlier on the downside, I will recommend you to buy it only if you see it trading above these levels. Then you can expect first target at 1825 and then at 1835. Now let me share that 1840 and 1850. These two levels on the upside, first 1820 and then 1850. If and only if gold trades above 1850 any point of time in next week, next to next week, or next to next to next week, you can consider that it is trying to reverse and it may try to achieve the next destination at 1875. 1900. Only and only if it trades above 1850, we can consider that it is going to achieve these levels for once. Even if it has to drop, it may achieve those levels. Beyond that, certainly little more bullishness is confirmed. Beyond 1900 and 1920, sky is the limit. Remember, it has reversed completely. It is going to fly high and you can keep your positions. You can keep your long positions there. On the downside, now I will recommend you to sell here at 1807 levels. Below that, 1800. Watch out for this 1800, very, very strong support. And then the next support at 1790, 1788. Rather, I will say 1791 and 1788. These levels are going to be very, very strong support here. And hence, you have to be watchful of these levels only and only if it breaks below 1788. Little more support at 1780 can be gathered. And below that, it may try to break strongly for 1750, 1725. In between also, 1740 and then 1725 levels. Now, be cautious of these levels, certainly. I do not see gold breaking below 1780 levels at least, but these are markets and yes, if it has to drop, it will drop at once so that the reversal gets easy. Also here you can 1818 and 1820, these two levels rather, so you can buy at 1818 itself and keep your positions accordingly. Trade accordingly, trade profitably. Do not forget to like, share, subscribe and comment. Do not forget to press the bell icon. Join my mentorship batch. Join my Cygnus group. Do watch the daily analysis as well. Please share across the video. Please like, subscribe and comment. Thank you very much. Have a great profitable trading week ahead. Thank you.